Hey guys. All right, so last week Adam asked us a question. He said, have you ever had a celebrity or someone you really looked up to in your life do something that totally just let you down? And I've definitely had a moment like that. So a few years ago, I was at this big event. It had live worship, had live bands playing, and there's this one particular band with this one particular girl that really stood out to me, that I felt like she seemed like someone I want to be like, someone who loved Jesus so much, someone who just seemed so authentic in her faith. And so after that event, I decided that I wanted to get to know more about her, and I wanted to follow her on all her social media platforms. So I go home, I find her on Instagram, and I start following her. And after I follow her, I start looking through her posts and kind of scrolling through, and I start realizing that the posts that she's posting, the things that she's putting on her Instagram, are portraying something totally different than the way she portrayed herself on stage that weekend at that event. And I remember having this moment of like, man, I'm so disappointed, I'm so let down, and I don't want to be this for someone else. I don't want to be someone who, someone follows my Instagram account and they start scrolling through my posts and they think to themselves, man, she's really different than how she portrays herself on a Wednesday night or at church or wherever it may be. And in that moment, I realized that I'm an influencer. And that's what I want to talk to you guys about today. So you guys know the term influencer. You know that there's people who literally it's their full-time job, it's their career to be an influencer. So what they do is they post videos or posts on their Instagram or whatever it may be, saying you should buy these products, you should buy these clothes, use my code to get this discount. You guys know all about this because it's like the thing now. But here's the thing, you don't need to have thousands of followers to be an influencer. In fact, every single one of us are influencers, and we all have people in our lives who we influence, okay? It could be your teammates, it could be your classmates, it could be younger siblings, it could be younger cousins, it could be people at your work, it could be customers who come into your work. It doesn't matter who it is. There are people in every single one of our lives who we influence. And God cares a lot about this. And God is actually the one who gave us this ability and this privilege to be influencers. So last week, Adam talked about the Sermon on the Mount and how this is one of the most famous sermons that Jesus ever gave. And I want to talk about that again with you guys today, because he talked about how we should maximize our influence in the Sermon on the Mount. So this is Matthew 5:13-15. And the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus talked about how we're the salt of the world and we're the light of the world. And he said, like a city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden, no one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your good deeds shine out for all to see, so that everyone will praise your heavenly Father. Okay, so Jesus is saying, maximize your influence by being salt and light in the world. And you guys are like, what does it mean to be salt in the world? Okay, so think about salt back in Bible times. So back in the Bible times, salt was used for everything. So they didn't have refrigerators back then, so they used salt to preserve food. They also used salt to disinfect wounds, to heal wounds. They used salt to make things taste better, just like we do today. And so salt was used all the time. And so Jesus used that analogy because it was used so commonly. People understood that, the people got that. But really what it's saying is be someone who, just like salt makes things taste better, be someone who makes things better. Be someone who heals, who protects, who preserves. Be salt in the world. And then light, you guys know this analogy. We talk all the time about being a light and letting your light shine so that others can be pointed to Jesus. You guys know that in a dark room, light stands out, any little speck of light. And so be someone who stands out. Be someone who's different. Again, be someone who points people to Jesus. And guys, like I said, all of you have people in your life who you can do that for. All of you have influence. A few weeks ago, I was at a family reunion. So my dad has 12 siblings. So I have over 60 cousins, okay? And they all live in a different state, so I only get to see them at these family reunions twice a year. And so I have a bunch of little cousins, and my one cousin came up to me at this family reunion, and she said to me, Caroline, I just want you to know that you're someone that I really look up to. You're someone who I really admire and just look up to in my life. And I remember feeling super humbled and super honored in that moment. But then I also remember thinking, like, man, I hardly ever even see you. Like, we don't get to interact a ton. Like, it's crazy that I'm someone you look up to. And it was just that reminder to me that we all have people who look up to us who would have no idea, would never expect they look up to us. And so all of you girls, do you have girls who follow you on your social media page? Little girls who look at your posts, see what pictures you're posting, and think, you know what, because she posts that, it's okay for me to post something like that too. Or because she's dressing like that, I'm gonna dress like that too. Or because she commented those things, it's okay for me to comment that too, and for me to think that way, and for me to use my words that way. There's little girls who are looking up to you who you may never guess will be looking up to you. And guys, same for you. There's guys who look at the comments you post on those gamer sites. They look at your comments and say, hey, like, all right, that's how he's talking. That's how he's thinking. Those are the things he's going to post. Like, I'm going to do the same because I want to be just like him. And so, guys, you're an influencer. It's a big deal and it matters. And the thing is that Jesus wants us to be someone who attracts people to him, not distracts people from him. And so how can we use our social media platforms to do that? How can we use our social media platforms to attract people to Jesus and to be a light and to be salt in the world? All right, thanks, guys.